Remember when humor was actually really funny? Our scripture reading today comes to us from the book of Psalms, Psalm 51, verse 8. Let me hear joy and gladness. Let the bones that you have crushed rejoice. Probably nearly 20 years ago, I went to a Hal Holbrook Mark Twain Tonight at Bloomington. Hal Holbrook, but made famous doing an entire routine of Mark Twain as the great American author. Now, Mark Twain died in 1910, but Hal Holbrook's sketch was always from the writings of Mark Twain. Hal Holbrook was quite the consummate Mark Twain expert. And what I found amusing in the Hal Holbrook production was how timeless these quotes were. Mark Twain died in 1910. And yet, making fun of foreign affairs, politicians, life and family, as he did well in his writings. Suppose you're an idiot and also a member of Congress, but I repeat myself. I found myself going, some things never do change. And, you know, whether it's shopping carts with wheels that don't spin or turn or keep angling us in the wrong direction, or, you know, comedy just being good-natured and fun and still treating the honored guest with respect. You may remember the television series with the Man of the Year and Celebrity Roast, usually hosted by Dean Martin. It didn't have a political preference. Certainly, Mark Twain poked fun at both Democrats and Republicans of the 19th century, where we think, and often with nostalgia's eyes, look at that as a time when there was dignity and honor among men, when certainly there was just as much of what causes chaos today causing chaos then. And partisan humor was not at the center of comedy. Think of Bob Hope, Johnny Carson. The simple goal was to make people laugh, not to insult them. Lucille Ball, Jackie Gleason, George Burns. Family life comedy like The Dick Van Dyke Show, The Brady Bunch, Leave It to Beaver, The Addams Family, The Munsters. The comedy of Bob Newhart on the telephone, Rodney Dangerfield, not getting any respect, or just the plain zaniness of Jerry Lewis, Phyllis Diller, Robin Williams. Domestic complaints, covered by Joan Rivers. Senior life, we still much love the Golden Girls. Small towns, Andy Griffith, Don Knotts. What do all these various comedians, all talented, have in common? They had comedy of a kind that made you feel good, and we still have it in syndication to this day. And we find ourselves captivated, just as I did watching Hal Holbrook, at how timeless this dated material is. Some of our syndicated material is approaching 70 years. And what happens when we can chuckle? We tend to get distracted from our own situations and problems. We laugh along with people of opposing political beliefs and different life experiences because suddenly we were all just plain human. Hearts opened a little and weren't slammed shut. There was a lot more laughter and a whole lot less offense. And we still have, fortunately, family-friendly and non-offensive brands of humor. Now, there's always, has also been the offensive in your face, and they too become legends. But what seems to have timelessness is good old fashioned, shall I say, or constant good humor. And good humor will always make us laugh. And, more often than not, unite us rather than divide us. So, look for an old comedy. Listen to an old sketch or skitch. Who's on first is just as funny as it was 70 years ago. Let us pray. Gracious God, we thank you for the timeless sense of humor and the good-naturedness of poking a little fun at ourselves, but not at someone else's expense. Help us to be mindful that good humor brings us together, not insults and separates us. Help us to be good-humored, good-natured, and enjoy a laugh to see that our problems, which seem immense at the time, are actually rather small. Amen. Blessings to you and yours this day and always. Goodbye.